Christ's victory over sin and death, let us join our voices together to give glory to God.
Thank you.
pray. O God, who on this day through your only begotten Son have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
From the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name, the word of the Lord."
Thank you. reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ, has been crucified. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciples went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The gospel of the Lord.
It is nice to see all of you this morning and to welcome 20 visitors who are with us. So one Easter, in the Peanuts comic strip, Linus shouts, "The Easter Beagle is coming! The Easter Beagle is coming!" Snoopy, the Easter Beagle, tosses an egg to Linus, who says, thank you very much. And he tosses an egg to Violet, and Sally, and Schroeder, and Patty, all of whom thank him. Finally, Snoopy reaches into the basket to get an egg for Charlie Brown, but the basket is empty. Snoopy says to himself as he walks away, leaving Charlie Brown disappointed, "Sorry, kid, that's the way it goes." On the material level, we are sometimes disappointed. There are things going on in the world around us that we find frustrating. Some days, there doesn't seem to be enough time or enough money. Some days, we have aches and pains, doubts and struggles. And most of the other drivers on the road don't know what they're doing out there. Unlike ourselves, of course. On the material level, life is not always easy. But there is one reality on which we can always depend. That first Easter, the tomb was empty, as Mary Magdalene and Simon Peter and John discovered. It will always be empty because Christ rose triumphant, just as he promised. And so we come together with joy in our hearts. Today, Christians around the world celebrate that life has meaning, that life is redeemed. We rejoice that when our time on earth comes to an end, we have a lasting home in heaven. There is power in the resurrection of Jesus, which we celebrate with joy this morning. This power has sustained the Christian community for 2,000 years. It will sustain us as well. And we need to remember that the power of the resurrection is not limited to the end of our lives. We are called to share in Christ's victory today. The resurrection is power for us today because Jesus is alive and well and with us always. He's not just a memorable heroic figure of the past. Jesus is with us today. In the gospel we hear, and the Eucharist we share. And unlike the Easter beagle, with Jesus, the basket is never empty. With Jesus, there is always grace for the day and strength for the journey. The resurrection teaches an important lesson. Good and bad, hope and despair, joy and suffering exist side by side in the world. Jesus didn't avoid pain and suffering. In fact, he embraced his cross as part of God's will, as the price for our salvation. Sometimes we set ourselves up for frustration and sadness by expecting, if not demanding, Easter without Good Friday, success without effort, and a good life for ourselves without being willing to die to selfishness and sin. Easter and Good Friday were intimately bound together in the life of Jesus. They are bound together in our lives as well. Part of Christian maturity is learning to accept both the ups and the downs, the joys and the sorrows of life. Learning to accept the cross as well as the resurrection, we are less immobilized by hardships or demoralized by life's challenges. Walking with Jesus, we can handle both good days and bad days in faithful, loving ways. Let's hold firm to the most important resurrection lesson of all, that good is more powerful than evil, that life is stronger than death. Let us reject the old yeast of corruption and wickedness and celebrate with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Easter reminds us that we can do more than endure tough times. We can triumph because Jesus loved us even unto death, whose chains he broke forever. You may have heard the story about a little boy who often went to church with his grandparents. Grandma sang in the choir, and she loved doing it, but she would get frustrated when she saw Grandpa falling to sleep during the service. So she came up with a plan. She promised her young grandson 50 cents every Sunday morning if he would poke Grandpa in the ribs when he fell asleep to wake him up. Well, the plan worked very well until Easter Sunday morning. That morning, the church was packed, as it is today. And Grandma noticed with alarm that right there in the middle of the congregation, Grandpa had fallen asleep. He was even snoring. And worst of all, Tommy was not waking him up. After the service, she found her grandson and said, "Tommy, what happened? You knew I was going to pay you 50 cents if you kept Grandpa awake." Tommy said, "I know, Grandma. But Grandpa promised me a dollar if I'd let him sleep." Brothers and sisters, Easter calls us to wake up, to shake off the darkness of sadness and sin. It would be a great thing if more of us would imitate the enthusiasm found in a third grade classroom one Easter. The teacher had been telling her young students about how Jesus was crucified and then placed in a tomb with a great stone sealing off the only way in or out. Wanting to share the excitement of the resurrection and the surprise of that first Easter morning, she asked her students, "And what do you think were Jesus' first words when he came bursting out of that tomb alive?" a hand shot up in the rear of the classroom, belonging to a very excited little girl. Almost leaping out of her chair, she said excitedly, "I know, I know." "Well, good," said the teacher. "Tell us." And extending her arms high in the air, she sang out, "Ta-da!" Not very biblical, but I loved the enthusiasm. Easter calls us to wake up and to renew our trust in Jesus, who died for us, who rose for us, and who calls us today to walk in the new life he offers. Thinking about the problems the world faces, about the challenges in our own lives, the remedy seems clear. We need Jesus. We need a Savior. And the good news is, we have one. Jesus is here with us this morning in Canadian County. Let us open our hearts to the presence of the Lord. Let us allow the power of the resurrection to fill our lives. And let us do our best during this Easter season to share with others the hope and strength we find each day, because we are doing our best to walk with Christ, our risen Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we renounce Satan and his works, and promise to serve God in his holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God? Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you? Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Amen.
Come to the river, flowing from the body of
in peace. Let us offer our prayers to the Lord.
Let the power of the resurrection fill the church, empowering each Christian to spread the good news of the risen Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace of the risen Christ, which surpasses an understanding, wash over nation and world, bringing unity and harmony. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let the God of creation, who found it very good, bless and increase our efforts to restore, protect, and enjoy the natural world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the God who led the Israelites to freedom through the Red Sea liberate victims of human trafficking and those enslaved to sin and addiction. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who were baptized, those brought into full communion with the church, and those confirmed last night, that they will be empowered by the Holy Spirit to build up the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the risen Christ, who suffered death out of love for us, renew our parish this Easter and give us an ever greater share of his Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, look with favor on your people this day, who rejoice in the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ. Hear our prayers and answer them according to your gracious will, for we offer them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray now, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exalt him with paschal gladness, O Lord. We offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the ending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Gives you praise, for through your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John Nepomuk, with blessed Stanley Rother, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you, and your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Gathered as God's people, at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a couple of announcements today. Our Mother's Ministry is hosting their second annual tea party next Saturday, April 6th. Free child care is available, and you can go online to register. On the round table in the gathering space, you'll find some Easter reading that we hope you'll find helpful. There is a Word Among Us daily meditation book, a Living Faith booklet, and Matthew Kelly's A Beautiful Eucharist book. Just a reminder that Easter, unlike the thinking of some people, it's not the end where we can go back and, okay, I'm tired of being spiritual, now I can do things my way once more. No, Easter is the beginning. It is the source of life from which the church has sprung. So I invite you to do some spiritual reading, to stay faithful in prayer, above all, to let the Lord be your guide each day. I want to express my thanks to everyone who's participated in the liturgies of Holy Week. Thanks always to my friend, Deacon John. And special thanks to Robert and Art and our choir and musicians. It was just lovely. Thank you so much. And thanks again for being here. I hope that you have a happy and a holy Easter season. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion deliver you from every assault of sin. May he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.